All right, so I told y'all this was going to be improved at some point in time, so let's go ahead and improve it. My forced function technique for, I say my, like it's owned me. It's inspired by many, many people. And I went on looking on YouTube and I saw a video where a guy was like, new way to solve quadratics and all that good stuff. And I don't really like A, the limitations they put on it, and B, like how many steps they did it. You can see my little video about this. This is really just knocking it out before I realized, wait a minute, part of the reason why our kids struggle is because they don't like fractions and things like that. And if I say, oh, look, let's do this problem where it's really hard and they have fractions, it's an equation. They don't have to use fractions. Just know that if they end up getting in that situation where there are fractions, they may end up having to reduce at the end. And as I tell my students, you can't be scared of fractions and large numbers. If you're going to be scared of fractions, you're going to have to deal with large numbers. So, that being said, it's an equation. I can do anything I want to it, right? So, let's say I'm looking at number one. I'm going to go, this is just me knocking out examples. By the way, my steps are four steps. One, two, three, four. Okay? Yeah, I don't know what's going on. All right, four steps, right? One is B over 2, or half of B is your center. My handwriting's atrocious. You're going to have to get over that. Step two, center squared minus AC equals distance squared. Step three is square root both sides and clean up. And step four is to write your answer that may have to get cleaned up too. More likely has to get cleaned up if it was something that would factor nicely to begin with, or if you had to enlarge it to avoid fractions. But you have negative center. Technically, I guess I could have done negative b over 2 is the center, then just have center plus or minus the distance. It's up to you. You decide when your kids would lose something. Plus or minus distance all over A. And that's my new quadratic example, or whatever you want to call it. All right, I might do one then erase. So on this one right here, if I had B over 2 as my center, I'd have a fraction on step one, and that right there is going to be enough to freak out people. So I'll just make a new equation. I'll double it because I'm going to half it in a second. If I double it, it's going to be even. Eighty-four, not a one, equals zero. All right. Now I've made a new equation. Great. A, B, C. You guys are math teachers. You know what you're doing here. So my center is B over 2. So that's my B is negative 2. Half of that is negative 1. Now I have center squared. Negative 1 squared is 1 minus A times C. A is 10. C is negative 84, so that's positive 840, right? That's going to equal 841, which is my distance squared. Square root both sides. Luckily, well, I'm a math teacher, so the square root of 841, that's just 29. So my D is equal to 29. That's my distance. So my little center is negative 1, but I'm 29 spots away from it. Great. X equals my negative center, negative of negative 1 is positive 1, plus or minus 29, all over my A, which is 10. So 1 plus 29 is 30. 30 over 10 is 3. 1 minus 29 is negative 28. Negative 28 over 10 is negative 14 over 5. Right? There we go. Now I'm going to go to my eraser so that other problem doesn't disappear. Right, next problem. I'm already even for my B, so there's nothing to change. All right, so my center is half of this, which is just negative 3. So I have negative 3 squared is 9 minus my outside. 4 times negative 8, negative 32. That's 41. That's my d squared. Square root both sides. Square root of 41. Time to clean up my square root. My distance is the square root of 41. Looks good to me. All right. Now I just have x equals. By the way, that's all the work. Like, boom, it's done. Like, that's what I love about this. It's like, it's as easy as factoring. Not quite as easy as factoring. That's a lie. It's almost as easy as factoring. I love completing the square. I think completing the square is the easiest thing in the world. It is noticeably easier than completing the square. It's a part of my heart that just broke saying that. So do my best not to spread that around, but this is like easy, easy. All right, my center is negative 3. So negative center is positive 3 plus or minus square root of 41 all over my a, which is 4. Boom, done. Well, I just grabbed a bunch of random problems from Infinite Algebra 2, just so you know. And I grabbed like 10, said, give me something ugly. And of course, not everything's ugly. So there we are. My B is even. Center is half of that middle, which is just 2. 2 squared is 4. I can't even write that down. Minus outside. 11 times 9 is 99. 4 minus 99 is negative 95. That is d squared. All right, next step, take the square root and clean. Square root of negative 95. Well, I get an I outside. 95 is 19 times 5. 5 and 19 are both prime, so square root of 95 equals d. X equals center, negative center, negative 2, plus or minus I square root 95. All over 11. Bam. This guy right here, middle is odd, so I'm going to double it. 4x squared minus 18x minus 136 equals 0, right? My center is going to be half of 18, which is negative 9, right? Square that's 81 minus 4 times 136. 4 times negative 136 makes that plus, right? That's 400, not 4, ha 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 ha. 544. Is that right? Oh, yeah, that is right. All right. That is going to be 625, oh how convenient, equals d squared. Square root both sides, square root of 625 is just 25, so my distance is 25. So now I write my answer, x equals negative center, positive 9, plus or minus 25, all over my new a, which is 4. 9 plus 25 is 34 over 4, which is 17 over 2. And then 9 minus 25 is negative 16 over 4, which is negative 4. Notice right here, that guy right there, he would have factored just fine. I didn't have to force him to factor. And that is, again, so it's like not like, oh, we're not going to teach factoring anymore. Again, factoring would have been faster there. Of course, you may have gotten a lot of kids to give up trying to find 136, factors of 136 that subtract to 9. But, you know, this guy here, the center, is the B is already even. So the center is negative 3. Negative 3 squared is 9 minus the outside, that's 33. That is going to be negative 24. That equals d squared, square root both sides, and clean. D equals I, 24 is 6 and 4, so 2i square root of 6. Bad handwriting, good voice. All right, so now I have my answer. X equals negative of the center, 3 plus or minus 2i square root 6 all over 3, because that's my a. This guy over here, number 6, yeah, it really is that fast, by the way. He's odd, so 4v squared. Oh, I keep switching to x. I don't even know if that's the right thing. All right, plus 18v plus 8 equals 0. Center is going to be half of 18, which is 9, which gives me squared is 81 minus 4 times 8 is 32. 50, 49 equals d squared. Square root both sides, that's 7. D equals 7. Answer, x equals, it's v, I know. X equals negative center, negative 9 plus or minus 7. That's a 7, not a 1, all over 4. So negative 9 plus 7 is negative 2 over 4, which is negative 1 half. And negative 9, negative 7 is negative 16 over 4, which is negative 4. Number 7. Middle's already even. Now, I'm gonna be a little jerk here. Everybody here can reduce, and I'm not gonna lose my evenness. So a squared plus 6a plus 3 equals 0. Y'all see that? Yay. Doesn't bother anyone, I hope. Now my center. By the way, if I do that stuff, I'm pretty much not going to have, if y'all look, I'm pretty much not going to have to reduce later on, unless it factors. Okay, my center is going to be half of 6 is 3. 3 squared is 9 minus 1 times 3 is 3. 9 minus 3 is just 6. That is d squared. Square root both sides. Square root of 6. That's already cleaned up. X equals negative center, negative 3, plus or minus square root of 6, all over my a, which is just 1. So much faster than the quadratic formula. Again, everybody's even, but this time if I divide everything by 2, I'll have 5k, and 5 is not odd. I not even. Oh my gosh, I can't even talk. So I'll leave that alone. Find my center. That's going to be half of 10, which is 5. 5 squared is 25, minus 8 times 4 is 32. That's negative 7 equals d squared. Square root, square root. Clean it up. That gives me an I on the square root of 7. So d equals I square root 7. Answer, x equals, I know it's k, don't say anything to me. Same thing on the left side, that was really a. X equals negative center, negative 5, plus or minus I square root 7, all over my A, which is 8. Doesn't reduce. Amazing. Number 9. Hey, look, it would have been so nice to do number 9 just by taking square roots. Subtract 9, and subtract 7, divide by 9, square root both sides. You don't even have to rationalize it. But some people like a process. All right, my B is 0. So my center is 0. We don't have to worry about losing a sign. 0 squared is 0 minus 8 times c, 9 times 7 is 63. That's going to be my d squared. Square root both sides. D equals, well, I'm going to have an i. 9 times 7, square root of 3, 7. Keep seeing the same thing here. X, k equals 0 plus or minus 3. I square root 7 all over my a, which is 9. Great. Plus minus I square root 7. So much for my not having reduced streak. Handwriting's atrocious. I apologize. Middle's even, so that's nice. Center equals negative 3. Negative 3 squared is 9 minus 7 times 12 is 84. All right. 3 more 75, negative 75 equals d squared. Square root, square root. D equals i, 25 and 3. x equals negative center positive 3 plus or minus 5i square root 3 all over a. I mean, that's it. I just did 10 problems in 15 minutes.